Hello and welcome to this video on strengthening the gluteus medius muscle. This video consists of 10 exercises in which the MVIC activity will go from low to high. Strengthening of the gluteus medius is a critical component of rehabilitation in numerous pathologies of the pelvis and the femur, including low back pain, ACL injury, iliotibial band friction syndrome, patellofemoral pathology, and many more. In this next overview, I will show you all the exercises that will be performed and explained during this video. But for now, let's get started with the first exercise. The first exercise that makes it in this top 10 video is the lateral step-up. As described by Boren et al. In the year 2011 and by Moore et al. In the year 2020. This exercise generated an MVIC of 60% in the gluteus medius muscle. To perform this exercise, stand on the edge of a 15 cm box on a dominant leg and slowly squat down, lowering the heel of the non-dominant leg towards the floor before returning to the starting position. Progression can be made by increasing the height of the box, by adding a weight on the side of the non-dominant leg, or by increasing the height of the box while holding an extra weight. The next exercise in this top 10 video is the reverse clamshell exercise, as described by Boren et al. In the year 2011. This exercise generated an MVIC of 62% in the gluteus medius muscle. To perform this exercise, get into a side-lying position with your hips flexed at approximately 45 degrees, knees flexed and feet together. Then internally rotate the top hip by lifting the top foot away from the bottom foot, then return to the starting position and repeat this exercise. The next exercise is the side-lying abduction with internal rotation, as described by Boren et al. In the year 2011 and by Lee et al. In the year 2014. This exercise generated an MVIC of 63% in the gluteus medius muscle. To perform this exercise, lay in a side-lying position on the non-dominant side. Then flex the hip and knee of the supported side and abduct the dominant leg to approximately 30 degrees while maintaining neutral or slight hip extension and knee extension with toes pointing downwards. The next exercise is the single leg bridge, as described by Boren et al. And Philippon et al. In the year 2011. This exercise generated an MVIC of 64% in the gluteus medius muscle. To perform this exercise, start in a supine position, then extend the knee of the non-dominant leg to full extension and get into a bridge position by keeping the foot of the dominant foot on the floor and raising the hip off the ground to achieve neutral trunk, hip and knee alignment for one beat. Then lower the body back to the ground for one beat and repeat this exercise. The next exercise is the reverse clamshell with abduction. This exercise was described by Boren et al. In the year 2011, and this exercise generated an MVIC of 68% in the gluteus medius muscle. To perform this exercise, get in a side-lying position with your hips flexed at approximately 45 degrees, knees flexed and feet together. Then raise the top leg parallel to the ground, maintaining the height of the knee while internally rotating at the hip by bringing the foot towards the ceiling and returning to the starting position. The next exercise is the front plank with hip extension, as described by Boren et al. In the year 2011. This exercise generated an MVIC of 75% in the gluteus medius muscle. Get into a plank position with trunk, hips and knees in neutral alignment. Then lift the dominant leg off the ground, flexing the knee of the dominant leg and extending the hip past neutral hip alignment by bringing the heel towards the ceiling for one beat before returning to parallel. The next exercise is the reverse clamshell with abduction and extension, as described by Boren et al. In the year 2011. This exercise generated an MVIC of 77% in the gluteus medius muscle. To perform this exercise, get into a side-lying position with your hips flexed approximately 45 degrees, knees flexed and feet together. Then fully extend the hip of the top leg while maintaining the height of the knee. Then internally rotate the hip by bringing the foot towards the ceiling and return to the starting position to repeat this exercise. The next exercise is the single leg squat, as described by Moran et al. In the year 2011 and by Moore et al. In the year 2020. This exercise generated an MVIC of 82% in the gluteus medius muscle. Stand on the edge of a box on the dominant leg and slowly squat down while preventing the foot of the non-dominant side from touching the ground. Then slowly get back up again and repeat this movement. An alternative option for performing this exercise is by using a chair. Standing on the dominant leg, slowly lower the buttocks to touch the chair before extending back to a standing position. The last and final exercises in this top 10 video are the side plank abduction exercises, with the dominant leg up and with the dominant leg down. The dominant leg up exercise was described by Boran et al. In the year 2011 and by Udes et al. In the year 2014. This exercise generated an MVIC of 89% in the gluteus medius muscle. To perform this exercise, get into a side plank position with the dominant leg up while keeping shoulders, hips, knees and ankles in neutral alignment. While balancing on elbows and feet, raise the top leg into abduction for one beat and then lower the leg. While doing this exercise, maintain the plank position throughout all repetitions. If this exercise is too hard to perform, try using your upper extremity to support your weight. While doing this exercise, also be aware that the leg closest to the undersurface creates the most MVIC activity, thus being the best exercise to activate the gluteus medius muscle with a stunning MVIC of 103%. I hope you enjoyed this video on strengthening the gluteus medius muscle. If so, also check out my other best of videos and don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. For now, see you in my next video.